Kaufela. Hello and welcome. This is Check Your Freedom, and I'm your host, Thando Qaba. This is the only show that creates a platform for young people in Africa to be able to express themselves on issues that matter to us young people. Today, we are discussing culture versus the right to self-identify. Before we can start with our discussion, have a look at this.
What is the right to self-identify? The right to self-identify is derived from the broad idea that all individuals are free to choose their fundamental beliefs and to express these beliefs whether they conform with the majority or not. It is about respecting the idea of individualism and individual ways of being. Why should we care about protecting the right to self-identify? All progressive societies have tolerance as a key value they uphold. This means that everyone's views, even those in the minority, are respected. Protecting the right to self-identity is important and must be seen to be done. This allows for more and more people to get the confidence to self-identify without the fear of being persecuted or discriminated against for holding views that do not conform to the majority's culture.
Remember, you stand a chance of winning an amazing hamper from the Friedrich Naumann Foundation for Freedom. Visit www.checkyourfreedom.tv and access our amazing digital quiz to learn more about your freedom. It's now time to connect with our young panelists for the day as we discuss culture versus the right to self-identify.
Why is it important for young people to talk about the right to self-identify?
I think it's important to have conversations about self-identifying, because then we're able to find people who relate to who we are. We're able to find people who can relate to our life experiences, and we're able to find people who understand our worldview.
Humans naturally want to belong, and we should create spaces where humans belong.
Do you think enough is being done in your community to protect and uphold the right to self-identify?
Not enough is being done in Zimbabwe. Our culture is too conservative to the extent that it has become selfish. You know, if you get to a space and I can speak in English, but just because I belong to the Ndebele group, I want to speak in isiNdebele so that Tinashe and Gugu and everyone else around me will use that language because, hey, I belong to one of the other majority groups.
What can the youth do to protect and uphold the right of others to self-identify?
One of the other things we need to then carry forward as the youth is respect for each other and our beliefs. Because I think that in the race to self-identify, sometimes we may then overstep our boundaries and then infringe on the freedoms of others. But we must remember that each freedom comes with a responsibility, and my freedom can only exist if Gugu's freedom exists and if Tinashe's freedom exists.
And we need to get to a place where we are comfortable with the fact that people are going to be different from us. People are going to see the world differently from us. And we need to teach ourselves to be able to sit in those conversations, even if they are uncomfortable for us, because we want to learn and because we want to build relationships.
Enjoyed that discussion, and I hope you have too. We took our cameras to the streets to get more opinions from the youth. We asked them whether they believe their right to self-identify is embraced and protected in their country.
They don't embrace it. Like me personally, with the way I dress, the way my hair is, a lot of people would like look down on that. Because like they affiliate me with like Jamaicans and like Rastafarians and stuff like that, while I just did this for style.
I do believe that my society protects my rights to self-identify, because I haven't been forced to be who I want to be, and people have accepted me for who I have identified myself as.
I hope you enjoyed today's show. Remember to check out our social media pages and let us know what you think about today's topic. While you're online, check out the very interactive Check Your Freedom digital quiz, share it with your friends and family. Doing so puts you at a better chance of winning our amazing hamper. Thank you very much for tuning in, and we hope to see you soon next time. Goodbye.